Good afternoon, everyone, and welcome to the Ingalls Rink on a beautiful Saturday afternoon here in New Haven, Connecticut. Don Boyle, Dick Naramore alongside, and a host of others helping out behind the scenes. It's quarterfinal Saturday for Division I ice hockey teams, Hamden Green Dragons, Fairfield Prep, the battle here in Game 1, and Game 2 on GoGreenKnights.com. We'll have the Green Knights of Notre Dame take on Simsbury, and which should be a real good game along with this one here. And well, Dick, decided underdog coming into this one would be the Hamden Green Dragons. Down a little bit, very, very young team, but they have found their way through into the playoffs.
They have. And, of course, this is 1 year ago almost to the day. This is a rematch of the 2012 D1 quarterfinals where Prep beat Hamden by a score of 2-0. But, yeah, Hamden looked good against Glastonbury. I saw that game. And they came on a little late in the game, but they got it done.
Yeah, they won by the score of 6-2, Fairfield Prep, the only team in the Division I tournament, which includes 15 to draw a bye. 19-1 in the season. They just ran roughshod through the state of Connecticut, overpowering all, and it'll be interesting to see how things play out here. They're only lost to a Massachusetts team, one of the top teams in the state of Massachusetts, and Catholic Memorial in their annual affair at the Wonderland of Ice.
Yeah, Prep comes in, Don, with an impressive 107 goals in the regular season. That's a 5.35 goals for average and 29 against for a 1.45. So they are clearly a scoring machine. Hamden, on the other hand, 58 goals in the regular season for a 2.9 and unfortunately a 73 goals against for a 3.65.
Yeah, they're going to need some strong defense tonight. I really think for Bill Veneris' squad, if they want a chance to beat Fairfield Prep, they got to do one thing. They got to stay out of the penalty box because the Jesuit special teams play is outstanding.
And, yeah, I think the best Hamden could hope for is a goal sequestration by Prep.
Well, I like that. I like that. Well, we've had the introduction of the starting lineup, and we're awaiting the playing of the national anthem on this beautiful Saturday afternoon in New Haven, Connecticut. While they play the national anthem, we'll step aside. We'll be back right after these messages.
All that saturated fat. Why not try Longini sausage instead? Other leading brands contain more than twice the saturated fat than Longini. Made with all natural ingredients, perfectly spiced with just enough salt, Longini sausage is the healthier choice. Made fresh locally in New Haven since 1950. Look for the Longini label in your grocer's fresh meat section.
Ivy League Landscaping is a family-owned, full-service design and build landscape company which services Southern Connecticut. We offer digital landscape design and installation. Our interlocking concrete paver system will add beauty to your patio and walkway. We share our location with our own Sound View Landscape Supply. Please visit us at 50 Industry Drive in West Haven. Ivy League Landscaping, from custom design to seasonal maintenance and supplies. Visit our website at ivyleaguelandscaping.com.
All right, terrific rendition of the national anthem. It always sounds the same here at the Ingalls Rink. The music man down press row plays it each and every time. And, of course, you know, Bulldogs out practicing prior to the start of this game, Dick, and they looked like they were high-flying in preparation, of course, for some tournament hockey next weekend.
Getting ready for next weekend, exactly.
So we're just about set to get going with this one. Both teams huddling around their goaltenders, getting ready. Last-minute preparations. Of course, Fairfield Prep upset in the semifinals a year ago by the Glastonbury Tomahawks, who went on to the championship game to face Notre Dame of West Haven. Now it's Hamden's turn to try to strike the big dog in the state of Connecticut here.
They can do it, but as you say, they gotta play out of the penalty box and get a few quick goals and try to gain some momentum in this one. Prep is a high-scoring team and very powerful. One to watch.
There's actually going to be a lot of hockey played throughout the state of Connecticut here. In the state of Connecticut over the next 24 hours or so, games being played today. Xavier and Richfield playing at the Bennett Rink at 2:30. Should be a good one. We'll try to get some updates through the Twitter feeds. We also have at the Ingalls Rink later today, Notre Dame, West Haven, Simsbury, and of course, Darien and St. Joseph's taking each other on there in the Terry Connors Rink. That's a 7 o'clock game tonight in Stamford, so we could make that one.
And I believe the D3 got moved today as well, so a lot of hockey.
I didn't take that one off, but so here we go. And we're just about ready to go.
Fairly decent crowd on hand here. Not bad for a quarterfinal match. Both student sections raring to go.
Check.
There you go.
Okay.
All right. I was playing with all your volumes and going, it's not working, it's not working.
My wife plays with my volume a lot, too.
All right, we're just about set to get going. Looks like Matt Beck starting in goal down to our right-hand side for the Jesuits of Fairfield. He's a good one, and he'll be fun to watch here today. And Matt Hoff gets a starting goal for Hamden as we're underway, and the Jesuits will control. They travel from right to left, and moving it along is Sean Henry. Fires one high and wide and up off the glass. Brown will keep it in at the left point, try to carry along the wall. Puck will bounce behind the net, and it's quickly collected by Joey O'Connor. Terrific. High school hockey player for the Hamden Green Dragons. Puck fired in, save is made. It's going to be quickly covered for a faceoff to the left-hand side of Matt Beck. So shot on goal for Hamden. Good start.
Quick little bouncer there, too. A little tricky. Goalies always want that first save to be, you know, a nice sure one. Oh, I guess that actually wasn't a shot on goal. It was whistled offside. And faceoff right into the... prep bench there, Don.
Nobody heard the offside whistle. Rather loud in here today, isn't it?
Tis.
Not the biggest of crowds. They will grow as the semifinals will be played here next week in divisions 1, 2, and 3, Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday. Off the right wing side, it's Connor Henry. Slips it in front, and it trickled off the stick of Bargiello, prolific goal scorer. Trying to crash is Galloy to keep it in along the boards for head coach Matt Sather, one of my favorite coaches in all of high school hockey. This is Carroll on the rush for Hamden. Stops. Fires it. Missed the net. Long cam to the near wall. Riley will play it back behind. Players scrum after it. Comes free to Billy DeMore. DeMore snaps a cross-ice pass. Too long. Goes for icing. And a face-off back in the Jesuit zone. Still scoreless here early in the first.
Of course, these two teams, Don, the only two teams here, at least at Ingalls today, play purely a Division I schedule in conjunction with their out-of-state schools, too.
Yeah, Hamden goes out and plays a lot of tough teams in the state of Massachusetts and beyond. Likewise, for Fairfield Prep, they take on a lot of New Jersey teams. And, of course, they play in that Mount St. Charles tournament, which they won this year, which was a terrific, terrific win. Won that in overtime. Hamden trying to work it out. They scrape at the center. It's deflected back in off of Matt Wickman and collected and retreating with it is Coleman. Coleman plays it up the near wall. Brown trying to challenge to keep it in along the boards. He looked like he overskated it. Able to recover, get it to Wickman. He is magical out of the corners. Works it up the boards. Plays it back along on the cycle. The puck is tipped around, changing sticks very quickly. Finally, it's controlled. Moved ahead by Coaches. Quick shot, and that rattled maybe off a Hoff and into the corner.
Yeah, he got a piece of that, Don. Great save.
Lockery trying to keep it in. He cannot. Fairfield Prep won the SEC Division I ice hockey tournament with a convincing win over second-seeded Notre Dame of West Haven. They have played three times this year, and Fairfield Prep has beaten Notre Dame all three. Puck to the far side. Carrigan trying to maneuver it across that red line. Snaps it. Blocked away by DeMore. Collected by Regan, and he was quickly knocked down and back the other way. In transition, the Jesuits. Lockery skips it to the backboards, gives it a chase. Lockery comes up the wall. What an improving player he has been throughout the year for Matt Sather. He has scored some key goals. Carrigan trying to work it out. Still scoreless here early on. This is O'Connor retreating. Cuts in front of his own net. He was double-teamed. The puck is going to be plucked away. Taken by Pintricelli into the corner. Plays it back to the line. Galloy couldn't keep it in. Breaking a stick was Regan. He may have had a possible break down that wall right there, Dick.
Yeah, it's hard to do without a stick.
Taylor Cangelo to control. Will backpedal and loft it across to the right side. Castaldi banks it off the boards up ahead. Riley tried to propel it further, and it's going to be stolen away. This is Killoy, and the puck is played safely back into the Hamden net. Good start for the Green Dragons against this Fairfield Prep team. longer they can go with this score remaining tied, scoreless, or whatever, better off they are. With the puck squirting to the front of the net, Henry was bumped down on the play.
Great chance.
It was Carroll who put the weight into him. Now Brown maneuvers ahead. With a head up, lofts it off the body of Connor Henry. Now Sean Henry backing up the play. They are twin brothers. We'll play it down in to that Hamden zone. Puck behind the net. Scooped up by the coin. Played it up ahead. A big hit along the wall. That will keep it in. That was Brown throwing the weight around as he just clobbered with Scott. Leveled him there.
That was a big hit.
Barangiello to hunt down the puck. Perez will play it back behind to the far side. Fairfield Prep, certainly a much bigger team from a physical aspect. There's a puck out front. Quick shot. Score! Barangiello makes it 1-0. Connor Henry fed it in front, and the Jesuits have the early 1-0 lead. That's what they do to you, Dick. They just gobble up those loose pucks.
Just like that.
About 404.
Sorry, four. New math.
I'll teach you the math. You can't figure that. You only graduated from Dartmouth, right? Yeah, that's figures. That figures. Not surprised, Dick.
I majored in addition.
It's tough. You actually have to add by subtraction, right?
Right.
404, tab of the goal. Barangiello, Henry the assist, and it is 1-0. Wickman could not collect a long stretch pass. We'll chase it to the backboards. Icing had been waved off. Wickman banks it back behind, tried to leave it there for Coaches. Coaches kicking at it, knocked off his stick, and cleared to the wall by DeMatteis. They continue to clash along the boards. Jesuits lead it 1-0. Shot by Kaloy, and then a stop by Huff. Most of the action has been down to our left as the Jesuits will carry play. Puck squirts back out to center, and DeMore on it. He's so improved, isn't he?
Very fun to watch. Feet always moving. Great to watch.
And DeMore will collect. In his left circle, snapped it to the middle. It's intercepted, but the whole thing is offside as they had a player tucked in the zone. That was Regan who was knocked down on the play. So face-off upcoming, 1-0 Fairfield Prep, 4:04 the time.
Yeah, he's a great-looking defenseman, DeMore.
And you're right, there. He's a good one for youngsters to watch because he does keep those feet moving all the time.
All the time. Great vision.
Brown plays it to the Hamden line. Quickly poked back the other way. Angelo trying to swat at it. Tried to stay with it. He's a terrific hockey player for Bill Benares. He's got that rifle-like wrist shot, and he has the puck across the line. Cuts to the left wing. Tried to turn away from Henry. Squash into the boards, and he got banged up right there. I thought he really got hurt. For a second there with the reaction from that hit, but he's okay. He's up, and that's good news. Puck comes back to Angelo, tips it along. This is Regan trying to lead the attack. He's across the line. Shot on, blocked away. Centers it in front. Angelo digging after it. He knocked down Henry. Shot from the defenseman. Hit a goal, post it in. A score! And it's D'Angelo as he whacked it home. O'Connor put it on, and we're tied at one.
Pressure there, crashing the net. How'd I do this time, 547?
Perfect. Right. We'll see the replay on that one.
Henry, take a look shot at it from there.
You can see that puck. Angelo whacks it out of midair as he was knocked down and into the net. Terrific play. You can use this as your little monitor right here from when Mr. Lano plays instant replays for us. Yeah. Angelo with the goal. John O'Connor. And you got the time exactly right. 5:47.
Go for my master's degree now.
This is David White down the right wing into the zone. The high slot. And that shot scaled out of play. It was deflected up over the tall glass. 1-1. Hamden staying close here in the first with 8:43 left.
And they certainly need to do that, Don, because prep scoring that early is never a good thing for an opposing team.
Face off to the left of Matt Huff. Hamden coming in as the eighth seed in this tournament. Fairfield Prep seeded first. Hamden, as we mentioned earlier, knocking off Glastonbury 6-2 in round one. Chopping the blue line by Henry was muffled, stolen away by Chacoin, and played out the center. It's right back into the zone. Eric Perez, one of the youngsters out there in the ice for Hamden. Now Henry to control for Fairfield. Prep up to Wickman. Settles down the bouncing puck into the circle. Shot Hoff makes a save, and he'll hold for the faceoff. Special thanks to Scott Duff running one of the cameras. Danny Alvarado running the other. And Mike Lano at the controls for us. And, of course, Dick Naramore alongside. The voice of Cheshire Hockey over the last couple of years, Dick.
Yeah, tough year for the Rams. Tough year for the Rams.
Play is on, and the puck skated out ahead and lofted down ice by Chacoin. Nemoore chasing it, whacks it to the wall. Battling for it there is McKinney of Fairfield Prep. It's knocked off his stick to the front of the net. Beck made the save and then dropped it as that was chopped along by Cangelo, double shifting out there. There's a pass thrown cross ice onto the tape of Lockery, trying to turn in. The shot sticked away by Hoff and the puck into the corner. Goaltender has to come up big in tournament play. Got a game's first penalty. It's going to go against Fairfield Prep. And here's the whistle, and it'll be a boarding call along the wall. Matt McKinney, I believe, on the late hit there. Let's see who it'll be. There's a couple of choices. Actually, they're going to whistle Timmy Edmonds, the smallest guy out there on the ice, to the sin bin. And chance for the Green Dragons of Hamden here. 7:09 time of that penalty. Well, Jesuits can be very dangerous shorthanded also when you have Connor Henry and David White as your penalty killers up top, and you get Brown and Sean Henry at the points on the penalty kill. Green Dragons with Regan as one of their forwards up top. The Maddies is another.
It's an aggressive forecheck on a man down. Absolutely.
Buck controlled along the wall by Barnett, also out there right now. Cangelo playing the right point on this power play. O'Connor the left side. So they use the big shooting forward at a point on the power play. Cangelo, he has the puck right now at center. Played it up ahead. Bumped along by DeMattis. He took a whack from Brown. The puck back out to center ice. Green Dragons cautious with 62 seconds on their power play. They'll bump it down into the Fairfield Prep zone, and Sean Henry will collect from behind the net. Being harassed, puck nearly stolen away by Regan, whacked to the line and down ice. And, well, they're going to have to regroup now with Huff coming out of the net. Bargiello is trying to hunt down the puck right there. Cangelo trying to maneuver away from Nick Bargiello. Bargiello stays with him. Can't take the puck away. Knocked him down. Penalty upcoming. There's a touch by the Jesuits. We got a two-man advantage now. It's going to be a hooking call and a chance for the Hamden Green Dragons to take a lead. Tied at one here with 6:22 remaining in the period. You can kind of see that coming.
Yeah. Yeah, Prep being very aggressive on their forecheck on that breakout, but that was a little too aggressive.
So they get a two-man advantage for 31 seconds. A shot, score! They win a face-off and they score! Pantera from the blue line, and Hamden in the power play will take a 2-1 lead. Wow.
Stay out of the box. Could be the theme of this game.
Absolutely. We'll see the replay on that one. Let's take a look at it again. Big face-off win. They send it across. Pantera with a quick shot. Breaks off of Beck and in. And that's a power play goal. They remain on the power play for 1:58. So the timing splendid on that power play with a two-man advantage.
Pretty sure that was an unassisted goal. But we'll wait to hear, I guess, Don.
It's going to come at 8:41 of the period.
Hamden goal. A power play goal.
You got it. Joe Pantera off the faceoff win. Faceoff man did a pretty good job helping get that puck back, but no assist doled out. Chacoin played it around to the far side. Hamden on top of Fairfield Prep 2-1. We've already had one nearly dark horse winner in this tournament in round one. East Haven had a 4-1 lead over Notre Dame West Haven. It took the Green Knights overtime to beat them, and they fired 72 shots on goal in that game, Dick.
Incredible. That goalie should get some kind of an award for that.
Oh, Zach Bouvet, he was terrific. Puck kept in on the steal by Lockery, lost his balance. Remember, Hamden's still on the power play here. The Maddie's trying to round the net. Puck stolen away. David White tees it up and drives one. That's deflected wide. He had a screen out in front, too. Just missed. Got a big shot. Terrific lacrosse player. Understand he might be heading to Amherst College. Small Ivy League. Broken stick. Uh-oh. It just disintegrated. Uh-oh. That was Chacoin. Lost that stick right there. That's $225 down the drain. He still might have a guarantee on that, however. There's a shot top angle. Beck made the save on a quick shot by Barnett. And the puck sent back the other way. 32 seconds remaining on the Hamden power play. That splinted lumber still down in the Hamden zone. Angelo will drop it off. Puck played up ahead by O'Connor. Stolen away and sent back the other way by Brendan Killoy. Seeing more and more time for head coach Matt Sather out there. He's part of the future squad. Oh, I got another penalty upcoming. This one on Connor Henry for the trip. Puck thrown down in as he tripped up O'Connor. And there's the whistle, and the power play will continue. Everything going Hamden's way right now.
Prep fans disagreeing with that call, but by my eye, it was absolutely a necessary call there.
As the third consecutive penalty against Fairfield Prep here in the first period. .10:38 time of the infraction. Here comes the announcement. Baggiello is out. Now it's a one-man advantage again. Baggiello is knocked down by Cangelo. Wicked check. Shot by Edmund. Saved by Hoff, and he'll hold for the faceoff. So Connor Henry in the penalty box as we speak.
Shots on goal all even so far at 5-5. Pretty even game so far.
D'Angelo with one of the goals for Hamden. Could play some baseball the way he batted that out of the air and in. Green Dragons taking their time. They have quieted the boisterous crowd from Fairfield Prep, the student body down to our left.
That they have. Although you don't hear the Hamden student section bragging too much quite yet.
Not yet. I guess they packed the Lou Astorino rink the other night for that game versus Glastonbury. They delayed the start, I believe, 15 minutes. Did.
It was full, yeah.
Puck behind the net.
Oh, scored it right out in front.
Indeed.
Of the cover up. Yep.
So the face-off upcoming. Face-off to the left-hand side of Matt Beck.
Both getting chased.
Off the face-off. Kept in. Cangelo shot blocked by DeMore. Now it's controlled by David White. Played up ahead off the left wing side. Centering pass. Oh! Hoff got a piece of that in the David White try. Off the feed from Kenny Kochus and a shorthanded bid. That was so close.
Time to detune that curve.
Wow.
Get that shot down a little bit.
What a chance. Joe Connor, so big, plays off the check of David White. They bank it down ice for an icing call against the Hamden Green Dragons. 2:44 remaining in the period. Hamden with a 2-1 lead over Fairfield Prep. And the Hamden Green Dragons continue on the power play. This has been extended from the 7:09 mark until this point. They've had power play chances.
Yeah, it's been a long streak. They got at least one to show for it.
Ventura up to the left wing side. Thrown across now by Carroll. Got popped up near, gloved down by Kevin Brown. I think Brown's a baseball player for the Jets, so it's, if I remember correctly. No, he's a lacrosse player, I'm pretty sure.
Nice glove save on the bench over there. The puck squirted out.
Face off to come at center ice. Calabrese for Hamden to take this draw against Lockery. Wickman trying to carry across the line. Now it's sent back down into the zone. Long shot blocked away. Players continue to battle for it. Now it's played off the glass and back down. Chased down by Pantera in his own zone. He'll scoot back with it. Plays it up the right wing side to Shacoin. Gave it away to Lockery. Whitman centers it, and Quote just takes a big hit. No penalty call. No, the back official will get it right there. The official closest to the play in the corner did not call it. That was a big run. That had to be a penalty. Charging will be the call. And this is going to go against
charging
the Hamden Green Dragons.
Take your pick. It was also a nice elbow there, too.
That's Matthew Carroll heading to the sin bin. Both teams were finally back at full strength until a moment ago. Well, the one thing you don't want to do when you have a one-goal lead is give this team a power play. 13:02, time of the penalty. So Carroll will go. Puck behind the net.
So prep's first power play here, Don. Let's see what. Oh, there's one for the fans.
They have given up a power play goal. Two-man advantage tally to Steven Pantera. Shots on goal rather even in favor by to Fairfield Prep by a couple there, Dick. 7-5.
Yeah, pretty even game. Of course, everybody just wonders for how long will it be.
Yeah, good
sort
point.
Of an anticipation. But Hamden's doing a nice job so far.
This is DeMoore. Played it around to Connor Henry. Go get it, Connor.
A little communication problem there.
Scotty trying to tie it up in the corner. Good job on the penalty kill.
Great
slowing
job,
it all
yeah.
down. Yep.
Absolutely.
This is Brown. Check that Sean Henry down the wing. Sean Henry into the zone. Henry carries low. Looks out front. Nothing going on there.
1 minute.
Less than a minute now remaining in the period. 1 minute remaining on the power play. White snaps it up front, tipped away by the alert goaltending of Hoff right there as Connor Henry was wide open. Bargiello to Henry. Connor Henry to David White. Back to the line to Henry. Sean Henry back to David White. Back into the middle of Henry. That's where they want it. Back to White. The one-timer is going to be blocked. Coming out to block it. Castaldi, and he clears it to center. Great play by the defenseman. White across the line. Has some speed. Turns to the wall and back to the line. Over to DeMoore. Tried to one-time it. Fanned on it. Got the rebound off his own skate and rifles one into the breadbasket of Hoff.
Yeah, that was a nice save. He almost had a nice screen set up, but far enough out, Hoff had a good look at it. A little smoke on the water, the frozen water.
Absolutely. One of my favorite songs. They could play this one over and over again. I'd be happy. Back to the line, Kevin Brown. You too. We like the old stuff, Dick.
Absolutely.
I don't know what that says about us, but. Coach is trying to sneak one in, and Hoff got a pat on it. He tried to go far side. Edmonds hustling after the rebound. The Lockery now. 10 seconds remaining in the period. 11 on the power play. This is Wickman. Wickman along the boards. They continue to battle for it into the corner of the coaches. Coach is trying to spin off the Cariangelo check. Got it to Wickman. The horn sounds, and that is a good first period for the Hamden Green Dragons, the number 8 seed. Through one, they lead the top seed. Fairfield Prep 2-1, Dick.
Great effort. Prep spent a little too much time in the sin bin there, but Hamden took advantage.
Shots on goal, 8-5 in favor of Fairfield Prep in the first. Goal scoring for you, Fairfield Prep on top, 1-0 at 4:04. Goal scored by Connor Henry. I should say by Nick Bargiello with the assist going to Connor Henry. There you go. Can't read my own
really?
Stat
yep.
sheet there.
Yep.
And then Hamden scored a pair at 5:47. First goal scored by Tyler Cariangelo. Just a great bit of movement in the offensive zone by the Green Dragons. They got it back to the line of Joe Connor, who got the assist there, Dick. And They tied it at one. Then they had that two-man advantage power play goal unassisted by Stephen Pantera at 8:41. So before we go to break, some of your thoughts.
Well, as we've said a couple times, Don, Prep spent a little too much time in the box. They had three consecutive penalties there, and it cost them the lead there with the second penalty, which would turn into a power play goal for Hamden. It's pretty darn even so far, though.
It's been interesting. We'll take a break. We'll be back with period number two after these messages.
Looks good, doesn't it? But you forgot something. All that saturated fat. Why not try Longini sausage instead? Other leading brands contain more than twice the saturated fat than Longini. Made with all natural ingredients, perfectly spiced with just enough salt, Longini sausage is the healthier choice. Made fresh locally in New Haven since 1950. Look for the Longini label in your grocer's fresh meat section.
Ivy League Landscaping is a family-owned, full-service design and build landscape company which services Southern Connecticut. We offer digital landscape design and installation. Our interlocking concrete paver system will add beauty to your patio and walkway. We share our location with our own Soundview Landscape Supply. Please visit us at 50 Industry Drive in West Haven. Ivy League Landscaping, from custom design to seasonal maintenance and supplies. Visit our website at ivyleaguelandscaping.com.
New Haven Foot Surgeons and Milford Podiatry Associates specialize in medical and surgical care of the foot and ankle. They have a state-licensed surgical center with a physical therapy center available for all patients. Physicians include Notre Dame graduates David and Robert Nowicki, along with Martin Pressman, James Krantz, and Jesse Parks. They are affiliated with the three major New Haven area hospitals, and they participate with most health insurance carriers. With locations in New Haven, Hamden, Milford, and Ansonia, New Haven Foot Surgeons and Milford Podiatry Associates is your GoGreenKnight.com connection to healthier feet. Visit them online at MilfordPodiatry.com.
And now, the winner of this year's prestigious Honda President's Award for Excellence in Dealership Operations, Customer Satisfaction, Sales, and Training. Curtis Ryan from Curtis Ryan Honda in Shelton. Celebrating 39 years in Shelton with a great reputation, great deals, and an extraordinary sales experience, this is Curtis Ryan's 9th President's Award.
Network. All right, right back here at the Ingalls Rink. My pleasure to have Dr. Tom Nagel alongside, who has certainly been so instrumental with the success of these ice hockey tournaments over the years. And here we are again, another year at the Ingalls Rink, Tom. This is terrific.
I'm happy to be with you. This is nice to be back at Yale.
You know, before the start of this game, I'm chirping Fairfield Prep. They're going to run their way into this state championship final. And lo and behold, who's put a little thorn in their side already?
They got to stay out of the penalty box. That's first of all. I think what they have four first period, and you know, but Hamden's giving them a game regardless. I mean, you know, we expected that. These two teams are—they're more than that. They're great programs. They're used to playing here, playing in the big game. So, and they know each other pretty well.
Absolutely. You know, the hockey tournament remains the same form as we had last year. I know there was some discussion maybe trying to change things. Rhode Island has a best 2 out of 3 championship series, and you were flirting with a few ideas. Can you let our viewers and listeners in on some of those meetings?
Well, yeah, essentially, the hockey committee had a proposal. Before we put that to the Board of Control at the CIAC, we shared it with our coaches on Super Bowl Sunday morning, actually. And it was great. We had a super turnout, standing room only. And the coaches had a very different take than the committee did. And I think the committee was coming from where it had been in the past. A smaller D1. There have been proposals in the past to have a so-called Elite Eight, that sort of thing. We had a different proposal, but it was a smaller Division 1, and the coaches didn't want that. They wanted to keep the divisions. I'll use the word balanced, generally balanced, to fill a 16-team bracket in D1, and then take the rest of the teams and redistribute them so that we could try to fill those. But in order to do that, we had to go to the Board of Control, and it was this past Thursday, I think it was. We went to the Board of Control and made a proposal, and we asked them for a 2-year trial period to in order to fill the brackets, to go below the traditional 40% winning percentage rule. And that's a big move for the lot. The hockey fan won't see the difference. A lot of, in fact, someone already said to me tonight, this afternoon, nothing's changed. Well, yeah, from the outside, it looks like nothing's changed. But for the Board of Control to do that shows an incredible amount of faith and confidence in the work that the committee does to try to put a great, you know, product out there on the ice. So it's a big move, and it's a trial basis. You could be sure that the Board of Control and other sports committees are watching to see how it turns out.
It is kind of interesting. You know, you've seen a couple of examples. Amity has some success, D2. They jump up to D1. They struggle a bit. They're down. Cheshire does a terrific job in D2. They jump up. They haven't gone down yet. And all of a sudden, they lose three or four players, perhaps unpredictably, right, you know, to the junior ranks. And they become really a struggling Division I team. How's that all playing into? Because you're seeing it across the board in college and in high school hockey.
You know, I was just talking to the principal from Fairfield Prep about their basketball team and how, you know, one kid transferred in from California, another kid, and now they're a powerhouse. And he said, we didn't expect that. And he said, when we talked to these parents about one of the boys transferring in, they never mentioned basketball, and the kid is a star. Same thing in hockey, you know, and it's five on the ice and five on the basketball court. It's a small number of players. It only takes one or two to change things. Either way,
that's right.
Somebody leaves for whatever reason, it changes the complexion of your team. Somebody transfers in, decides not to play juniors this year, it changes things pretty radically.
Absolutely.
I watched it at Glastonbury years ago. We had a young man by the name of Justin Timpano. He'd been playing juniors, came back, played for the high school, and made a big difference. We won a D2 championship. So we know that. And so each year when we put teams into our different divisions, we start with a database. So we start with numbers. But there's still, you know, that other unknown factor. So we try to get as much anecdotal information as well. And how do you look, coach? Does it sound like you've got all your guys coming back? Or what's your freshman class look like, you know? And you're always trying to work together with the coaches and just do the best you can. You know, with Cheshire, I look and I said to somebody, we didn't make a great decision with Cheshire. I thought we had a good decision at the time, but as you mentioned, things changed. And
you lose a couple guys. Yeah, you don't know you're going to lose.
And they had a tough season. They had a tough season. So we'll see where they end up next year.
For example, you got the stud defenseman here for Hamden. I hear O'Connor's going to probably leave and go to a prep school to try to earn that college scholarship. And I really blame the colleges, really, for some of this trickle-down effect that you see these kids feeling as though they have to leave the high school ranks to go play juniors or somewhere else.
Yeah, each student-athlete and his or her parents have to make those decisions, what's best for that youngster. Having said that, you know, I guess I'm a little old school. There would be nothing better for me to have scored the winning goal as time was running out, or the winning bucket as time was running, and then walk the halls of my school the next day and everybody patting you on the back. And, you know, and if I'm playing for a junior team and we go down to Philly and I do the same thing down there, who in my school knows that, you know? And I think for me, there's nothing better than playing for your school and getting the adulation of not only your teammates, but all your schoolmates, you know, that are here in the stands and that sort of thing. There's time, if you're a really good player, the coaches on the collegiate ranks and whatever, they'll find you.
Absolutely believe
that.
And
the time comes, the time will be there for you to do that.
Absolutely.
That's just my take on it. But,
you know, in closing, we know we have the Division 2, 3, and 1 semifinals all here at Ingalls next week. We'll be here enjoying it all. And then the little change because of Yale's success in ECAC hockey to the championship schedule.
Well, it wasn't even just Yale's hockey success. It started with at the NCAA level. The basketball committee at the NCAA went to their organization and asked to change their schedule for their playoffs. In doing so, it had rippling effects through the NCAA to all their sports committees, including hockey. When that changed, then the ECAC schedule changed. And when Yale won this past Friday night and got to be a home hosting team, that had an impact on us. we can't say enough over the years about Yale being a tremendous host for us. Our players throughout the state love being here. I just remind ourselves all the time that they're hosting us. It's their rink, their team. We wish them the greatest success. And they do everything they can to find those slots where we can fit in.
They really
do. We do that.
Yeah, and to me, this is the greatest venue in the state to play these championships. Yeah. Quinnipiac is a gorgeous place. You have Bridgeport, and of course, you get where the Whale play and things like that. They're all great, but something about this venue, it's just terrific.
And the upside of it is that on the Saturday at 1:30, which is usually the D1 slot, now we've got D3 playing there. It's kind of a marquee slot, if you will.
Yeah,
so
absolutely.
Great.
It's going to be terrific for them. Well, the officials are coming back on. I know you have work to do. And where's my boy George
Thanks,
Hall?
Son.
Where is my man?
Keep up the good work.
Where's George? Is he hiding somewhere?
Yeah, he's off in another ring.
He's off in another ring. Thank you, Dick. All right. Dr. Tom Nagel joining us. And back to Dick Naramore over here. Thank you, Tom. I appreciate it, Tom. All right. One of my favorite guys right there. That's for sure, Dick. Tom Nagel, Dr. Tom Nagel.
Chairman, yeah.
He's feeling sorry for Cheshire. He knows that perhaps they could have been down there in D2. So there you go. Well, we're through.
All right, Don, are you ready for today's trivia question?
I'm always ready for that stuff. You know what I feel about that. Go right ahead.
Okay, folks, hockey fans, first one to call wins. In what year was the longest state championship game? Who, how long, and what was the score?
I think it was Notre Dame Fairfield played in that game.
Go on.
Marty Roos's son scored the game-winning goal, I think, if that's the one I'm talking about. The year was... Oh, man. 2002.
Very close. Very close. Who did they beat?
Probably Fairfield Prep. No, I think it was Hamden they beat. I think it was I'm going to go with Hamden.
Okay.
But I could be way off on that.
All right. Well, we'll give the answer right now. There's no sense waiting. The anticipation could cause major heartburn out there.
Yeah, you don't want to tease everybody.
Exactly. The longest state championship game was a D1 game, Don, in 1999. You were right. Notre Dame of Fairfield defeated New Canaan.
New Canaan.
By the score of 3-2 in 5 overtime.
Wow.
5 overtime.
Wow. Well, we're in the second period just underway. Hamden defending down to our right. Both teams now back at even strength as Carroll steps out of the penalty box. So Hamden Green Dragons have done a terrific job with special teams play. They have killed off a Fairfield Prep power play, and they have also scored a power play goal. Henry centers it, and it's going to be blocked away as that hit Pantera, who scored the go-ahead goal on the power play. Back out to center. That's Kevin Brown on the far side. Beck and goal down to our left. You already met Mr. Hoff. Down to our right. Up ice on the feed. Across the line is Kerrigan. He fires it from the circle, and the blocker stopped by Beck. Puck into the corner. Angelo plays it back behind. Jousting over there for it was Brown along with, we get a whistle. And we had a player falling behind the play without a cap on. Losing his helmet was Sean Henry. That's why the stoppage in play. Trying to figure out why they were blowing that whistle.
Yeah, it's certainly a safety rule in high school, I believe. College, I don't think they stop for a player without a helmet.
Faceoff coming to the left of Beck. 2-1, Hamden leading. Scoreboard does read correctly, and they're looking for more. Boy, Carroll got it through. DeMore and in on Beck. He was forced to make a save as it continues. Good play here by Hamden early on.
Contested that extra hit on the goalie, but the whistle hadn't blown, and he's entitled to chip one time there. It's not like it was a slash.
Off the faceoff, the puck behind the net. Jesuits control it. Trying to wheel away from the forecheck as Galloy gave it away. Quick shot, score! Andrew Calabrese! And Hamden has a 3-1 lead over Fairfield Prep.
Seven.
Wow. Calabrese with the goal. How do you like that? Comes exactly 60 seconds in the period number two. That is an even strength goal. We'll see the replay on that one.
Exactly.
The puck came out, the quick shot, the save was made. And that was a save.
We'll try to pick up that. I don't know if we're going to have it there.
Yep, Calabrese with the goal. We'll try to bring that to you when we can. That was a save just prior to that. Riley will get the assist on the play.
That was some pretty work.
Puck lofted it, trickled off the netting. Now we'll see that replay again. Here's some great work by Hamden from behind the net, quickly out front, and a quick release by Calabrese, Dick.
Boy, I caught the D just looking, too. You can see two prep defenders right down there at the paint. Neighbor just watching.
Didn't have the feet moving.
The old head on a swivel.
Puck played ahead. Hamden leading it 3-1 over Fairfield Prep. It's their first game of the tournament. There's a turnover. It's taken right back. Oh, that pass intended for McKinney, and it was just off the mark from Ventricelli. Hamden on top 3-1. Well, the second-seeded Notre Dame Green Knights we mentioned earlier were taken to overtime by number 15 seed East Haven in round one. They had to win that one 5-4. They were down 4-1, so they're far from over. Across the line is Riscotti, and he's bumped off his pins.
Good check. He's fast, too, Riscotti. He's a fast skater.
Connor digging after that puck. It squirts free, and Joe's going to chase it down, and he gets some help. Controlled by Pantera, the sophomore defenseman. Joe Connor, good bank pass off the right. Stood up was Regan as he tried to maneuver past DeMore, and he was taken off his stride. Puck collected by Kaloy. Played it along, and puck comes out the center. Connor waits for it, sends it diagonally back into the Jesuit zone from behind the net. It is Billy DeMore up to the right wing side. Henry goes cross ice. That's easy pickings there. Knocked down was Chicoine, however, and back across the line. They move it to the front of the net. Oh, it squirted right free. Oh, that was a terrific play by Carrington. That was just a power move in, and then Cangelo couldn't put home the rebound. This is White breaking in. Snaps one high off the glass with a wicked wrister. Long carry on the center. Action up and down right now. I think Hamden would like to slow the pace down maybe a little bit, Dick. I don't know. Who am I to say?
They're putting great pressure on, though.
Chicoine to control. Plays it around the right wall. It's going to be deflected away. Battle for it in the corner.
You know, certainly from an experience standpoint, Don, I mean, Hamden with 8 seniors and Fairfield Prep with 9 seniors. So, experientially, they seem to match up pretty good.
All right, face off to take place. We've got some penalties coming up behind the play. Some matching penalties or just one? Yeah, just one.
It's been a
Regan.
Yeah. Regan.
So Regan to go. First penalty of the second period. So Regan in. I didn't see it. I don't know what that was for. We'll find out right now. Cross-checking. Okay, 3:12 time of the penalty. Fairfield Prep on their second power play. One here. They center it, and Whitman couldn't direct it towards goal. It deflected off his stick, and back come the Green Dragons the other way. Cutting across the line is Riscotti into the corner. Edmonds trying to stay right with him, and it'll be taken away by Edmonds as Riscotti fell down. Up fights coaches. Coaches coming off that left wing side. Carries in, plays it along. That's Brown at the left point. Whitman drops it down. Centering pass deflects off a stick. Lockery bats it away. Now coaches to take it. He's dancing behind the net. Wickman, left point. Brown snaps it off to Lockery. Centered it. It hit Hoff and went behind him. Lockery, out front shot, score, Wickman.
Wow, that was some great work.
That's a power play goal. Wickman was left all alone. Alert play by coaches and Lockery behind the net there, Dick.
Beautiful play. Man down. There's not much you could do there. They're all twisted around. Defense is twisted. Goalie's down. Very quick recovery by Prep. Beautiful.
Time of the goal, 4 minutes, 10 seconds. So Matt Wickman with the goal. They're going to call it unassisted. Boy, someone deserved an assist. Lockery from behind the net.
Yeah, I agree.
We'll look at the replay of that in a moment. Next whistle. Calabrese across the line, took a whack, but got it behind the net. So it's now 3-2. Hamden holding on to the one-goal lead. Connor Henry spins off of O'Connor, moves it up, bites his Bargiello, his shot, and ricochets off the skate of Pantera. Puck back behind the net. Players battle there. Bargiello ducks under the check. Puck squirts free. Carangelo picks it up. Carangelo working down the right wing. Being harassed by Bargiello. Got to cut across the line. Chopped that there by Kevin Brown, who did a nice job stepping up into the play. That was textbook right there.
That was.
We'll get a whistle.
A little extra here.
Let's see if we can pick up that goal a moment ago. And here it is. Here's that goal as we'll take a look. Great work by Lockery. Got it to Wickman in the score as he was being hit. Absolutely.
You could have almost argued two assists on that. The one,
absolutely,
first one,
yep,
wrap around. Oh, well.
I'm going to give them both an assist in my book right now.
I like that.
Yeah, yeah.
I like that. You're very kind.
Yeah. We'll be the official officials. Off the faceoff. Coaches plays it back to center ice as he tried to hit Kevin Brown with the pass. Connell played it over to Brown. Played a loose pass in the Hamden line. Canangelo snapped it along, and he missed a mark as he was trying to find Carrigan. Now the puck down below. Carrigan's brother, the older brother, was one of the stars a couple years ago when Hamden had a little double state tournament run, you might remember. This is Wickman off the left wing.
Great
Wickman
pass.
All alone runs through the high slot and carried it to the wall. Gets it back along the boards. Tied up by Carrigan, who's been, Cayangelo rather, who's been all over the ice. He's knocked down, no whistle there, and then returned. He knocked down a Jesuit.
Oh, boy.
Now you got O'Connor knocked down. Wickman shot, save, rebound, score! Kenny Kokas will tie it up.
Yeah, I hate to say that, but that was a defensive error there, bringing that puck back up through the slot.
5:44, the game-tying goal, and all of a sudden, the Jets was right back in it. Yep, trying to do too much.
That's right, the box was clear on that, right? That was a full strength.
Kokas with the goal. Unassisted, they call it. Wickman had the first whack at it. They're stingy on giving out assists here today.
Wow, they sure are.
Petroselli controlling back to the line. Shot through a screen. Saved by Hoff. Rebound quickly cleared away. As digging after was McKinney. Fairfield prep trying to throw the weight around now as Petroselli threw a check. Breaking through off the wing is John Henry. The backhand save. Hoff rebound. It's free in the slot. Players rapping at it. Petroselli will get it to the wall. Turns it top of the circle. Plays it back into the corner. David White to give it a chase and squirts free. And Chacoin will play it up ahead, and here's a break. 2-on-1 if they hurry across the line. Scotty is in, looks for the shooting angle, and Beck will come out and stop it with a right pad. Cut down the angle nicely. He had Barnett with him and elected to go for the shot. Not a bad decision. Kept it low, too, where there's a potential for the rebound.
The trailer, however, should have crashed the net much sooner. He was waiting for a back pass. He's got to crash. Get that rebound off the pad.
Puck sent down ice, icing against Hamden, face-off back in their zone, 8:03 remaining in the second. Fairfield Prep and Hamden tied at 3. We'll take a look at that last goal again. Oh, that scoring bit a moment ago. Let's see. The goal on the doorstep. Coaches, you could see him there, and he was left unattended.
Another one of your favorite songs, Don.
Yes, indeed.
Oh, Billy Idol.
Going back in time from the punk rock days. Puck back into the Hamden zone. Corner to chase it down to the near side. Battling along the boards with Bargiello. Scores free to the line. DeMore has it. Creeps top of the circle. Shot blocked by Carroll. Carroll up, and he's racing ahead. Picks up O'Connor on the wing, trying to turn around the defense of Malloy. Did a nice job to stick him along the boards, and Bargiello will take it back. Players continue to collide behind the play, and the officials now letting them go a little bit here in the second. Long pass. Intended for David White, instead an icing call. And we're going to see a penalty now behind the play for tripping. Wow, I believe it's going against Hamden Green Dragons.
Yeah, Hamden's doors open. Boy, they sure missed a hold down there, though, on O'Connor. O'Connor was just yanked down.
I don't know who's going to the box. Is it O'Connor to go? I don't know. I see two something. Now it's going to be
seven. Yeah. That's what it was. All right.
I guess when you only have five fingers on one hand, right, you got to use two to put the number seven up there. That's the second time Matthew Carroll has been whistled to the sin bin. Time of that penalty, 7:35. We're just midway through this hockey game, tied at three. Off the faceoff, it's controlled. Jesuits with a power play goal here in the period. Coaches centers it, deflected to the line. Edmonds along left side. Pass, shot, Lockery, save off as he went post to post.
Yeah, nice puck work.
Real big save there. Great pass, too. The way to look at that open post, man.
Kevin Brown, yeah.
Yeah, from the opposite point.
Face-off upcoming. Off the face-off, the puck down into the corner. Lockery battling for it there. Taken by Kochets. He's got a goal here in the second period. Back to the line. Brown to control it. Back up the boards. Chopped towards the slot by Wickman. Intercepted and sent back the other way by Chacoin. And puck back behind the Jesuit net. Battling for it there is Calabrese. He's got a goal for Hamden here in the second period. Brown will lug it along with 1:22 remaining on the Jesuit power play. Carries across onside, snaps off a shot. Huff makes the save, and he'll cover for the faceoff.
Another kind of a hold right there on the blue line everybody's yelling at.
I've been trying to figure out how the officials are really calling this game in a couple of instances. You know, the trips they're calling, the charging they're calling.
Yeah.
A lot of the other stuff they're letting go. It's kind of... kind of interesting. Battle for the puck on the far side. Connor Henry plays it back to DeMore. Over to Sean Henry. Up to David White. Plays it with the skate. White shot, tough angle off the side of the net with a good low shot. Bargiello collected. Bargiello trying to power his way to the front of the net. He did, but lost the puck. It squirts free and hopped over the stick of Connor Henry. He's whacked by O'Connor. David White to chase it down up the boards. He's knocked off the puck, and it's collected by Riscotti. And Riscotti snaps a pass through Carrigan, and it's down ice. That's DeMore from behind the net. Connor Henry. Cross ice, brother Sean. Sean Henry will carry down into the corner. Henry takes a look. Back around to David White. 28 seconds remaining in the power play with Carroll in the box for tripping. 3-3, 5:48 remaining in the period. Over to DeMore. Checkerboard pass. White tried to go angle pass in front. Got it back and popped it towards goal, and Hoff knocked it away. Connor Henry. Bargiello. Bargiello right through the goal mouth. Intercepted. Played in the line. DeMore keeps it in. Quick shot. Save. Score!
Eight.
Bargiello whacked it home, and Fairfield Prep will take the lead. Their second power play goal of the period.
They may say White got a stick on that.
Shot from the blue line will have to wait. I thought it was Bargiello, but we'll see the replay. I think Lano has it here.
Yeah.
Take a look. Going to be a good low shot from the blue line. You can see that there. And out on the doorstep,
right,
yeah, Bargiello, I think, knocked it home. As he was knocked with D. That was a rebound, too. DeMore with the helper. 9:30 time of the goal. Their second power play goal of the period. Well, we said in the pregame, well, we got a penalty upcoming here to Kevin Brown as he took a run along the wall on the far side. And that was a big hit. Knocked down with Regan. I'll tell you what, there's been a lot of action out on the ice here in this one. And there'll be a penalty upcoming here. Kevin Brown to go. I was just starting to mention, we had mentioned...
he had the assist.
No assist on that last goal?
Right.
Okay.
No. Bargiello from DeMore.
Oh, it was from DeMore.
That was the one before that.
Yep.
So Fairfield Prep whistled for the penalty. It's Brown. Interference, a call. 9:49 has been a kind of a penalty-marred game in a sense. We had three called on Fairfield Prep on the first. This is their fourth. Hamden had three consecutive calls, and they gave up two power play goals. Here's a steal by Edmonds down low, short-handed.
Tried to backhand it home, and Huff forced the cover. Jesuits lead it 4-3, looking for more with 4:45 remaining in the stanza.
Hamden can ill afford to play with that puck in the defensive zone. Gotta get control and get out of there quick.
Off the faceoff, puck wheeled to the far side. Connor Henry to collect it. Henry plays it back behind. Hamden on the power play, trailing 4-3. Now let's see how they react when you talk about the Green Dragons. What will they do here, down for the first time?
Down behind one, yeah.
Well, they were really down back in the first period. Let's not forget at 4:04, Fairfield Prep scored the game's first goal, and they quickly reacted with a three unanswered. Now they come back. Oh, out in front. It was Regan. If he could have pulled the trigger, the net was yawning at him right there.
Oh, boy. You got to use your gloves in the blue line.
Puck sent back down. Hoff to come out to play it. Trickles it up the glass. Drops on down. Cangelo has scored.
Oh, boy.
O'Connor couldn't kick at it. Stolen away by Connor Henry. David White trying to dance inside. He was knocked down in a play by Regan. The puck is finally chopped up ahead and full steam ahead for Matthew Barnett. Barnett carries, turns, lost an edge, tried to get it in front. It was intercepted and sent back the other way by Aiden Rush. So now from behind the net, it's Pantera. He was a power play goal scorer for Hamden back in the first. They throw it right in on Beck, and he'll shovel it to the glove and hold on for the faceoff with 21 seconds remaining on the Kevin Brown penalty. A little extra stuff going on after the whistle. No harm done there. Faceoff upcoming.
That was a little stay out of my crease love tap.
Whoops.
Prep starting to inch away now down on the shots on goal category, 18 to 11.
They hit the keyboard and gave Fairfield Prep 9 goals. They just scored nine goals in a matter of 0 seconds.
So do I get the assist on those?
All of them. 4-3 Fairfield Prep leading Hamden. We do apologize. Up ice it comes. Tight quarters here. This is Carroll across the line. Centers it! Beck will reach out and cover it. Oh, you had Riley digging. Carroll going. And on the doorstep, Calabrese. And again, you had a little pushing and shoving going on after the whistle. And the officials will let him stay out in the ice.
They are letting them play there. That was clearly a nice little cross check after the whistle.
.308 remaining here in the stanza. And an entertaining game. Shots on goal between the two teams, a total of 30. Hamden out shoot, I should say Fairfield Prep out shooting Hamden 18 to 12. They have the lead. This is Riley trying to cut across the line. Still in his skates as he was hit by DeMore, and he'll backhand it deeper into that Jesuit zone. DeMore to glide after it. Played it into the corner. Gave it away to Riley. Both clubs now back at even strength. Kevin Brown out of the sin bin. Hamden trying to get something going. This is Carroll. Carroll knocked off his stick by DeMore. DeMore shovels a backhand pass up the boards. Pantera trying to keep it in. Nice calculated wrist. And it's back behind the net. Galloy played it around. Calabrese will steal it. Chopped it towards net. Save is made by Beck as Carroll may have redirected that on top of the doorstep.
Very alert there, very alert.
Someone just sent me a text message. Thanks for fixing the scoreboard. Sorry for pounding on the buttons at the wrong time.
You sure that wasn't Scott Duff down the
game? Yeah, exactly. Hamden the control in their own zone. This is Castaldi. I know. Green Dragon fan just tuning in, be all bummed out. That pass found its way to McKinney. Nice move as he tried to sweep it around. Shot. Oh, Ventricelli with a follow-up from the slot. Just deflected wide. O'Connor hustles after it. Plays it up the boards right wing. Muscati tried to go cross ice. Got it there to Barnett. He's across. Has some shooting room. Good for the shot. Going to be blocked away off the skate of Aiden Rush. White will send it back the other way. He's knocked down. It's collected by Castaldi, and Greg Castaldi plays it halfway into the Fairfield Prep zone. 1:38 remaining in the second period. Fairfield Prep leading it 4-3 here. This is O'Connor. Plays it off to the left wing side. Turned up ice by Carrigan, and he's bumped by Sean Henry and knocked down. Puck on the far side. Kept in at the point by Chacoin. Got it out front. Carrigan tried to redirect it, then shovel it out front. That was intercepted. And controlled behind the net by the wheeling and dealing Mike Ventricelli. uses the glass to play it to the line. Glove down. Chacoin will keep it in. Chacoin plays off a check, but gave it away to Sean Henry. Hamden doing a pretty good job keeping it in momentarily. Now here's a 2-on-1 break. David White with Henry. David White over to Connor Henry. Back to White. Shoots. They score.
Beautiful.
That's how you work a 2-on-1.
Textbook.
David White with a goal. Connor Henry. You got to give him an assist, I think. Oh, boy, that was beautiful.
He could get a goal and an assist. On
Absolutely. 14:07 time of the goal, and Fairfield Prep for the first time with a two-goal advantage here today, 5-3 over Hamden.
Even strength goal there. Wow.
Well, you can see the trouble happen. Here comes the announcement on the goal. David White with the tally. Here they come again. Wickman shot, hop, the save. Connor Henry with the assist. Petroselli also picking up the assist on the play. And the puck back out the center, and it's tossed right back into the zone. So, 30 seconds remaining in the period. Hamden's going to have to battle back from a two-goal deficit. At one point, they had a 3-1 lead, and really a couple of penalties slowed down all their momentum. Fairfield Prep scored a couple power play goals. Now it's bumped down ice, 14 seconds. Wickman trying to chase it down. Has it behind the net, puts it in front. They're looking for more. This is Lockery, and he tried to dump it off, intercepted by Carroll. 3 seconds in the period, throws it to center, and it's sent right back into the Hamden zone, off the stick of Connell, and that's going to do it through two periods. That one belonged to Fairfield Prep as they score a bundle, and they take a 5-3 lead into the locker room, Dick.
Little turnaround, yep. Very nice. Some textbook goals in that period.
All right, we'll step aside here from our fine sponsors. Let's hear the sponsors. It's actually shots on goal. 12. And Hamden with 8 shots on goal through 2, what, 2013 in favor of Fairfield Prep.
Makes sense. That's the way the pressure went, too.
All right, let's see that last goal before we go, that terrific 2-on-1. We'll try to pick that up if we can. Here you go, the pass across, White to Henry, back to White, and you could have whacked that one in there, Dick.
Yeah, absolutely, with my straight stick.
Absolutely. All right, we'll step aside. We'll be back right after these messages.
Network Group, we are committed to offering simple and meaningful solutions to your complex problems. We work hard to achieve the highest levels of quality in our solutions to help your customers meet their challenging business needs. We're committed to delivering technology management solutions that offer security, reliability, availability, and performance. Visit our website, thebusinessnetworkgroup.com, for more information.
Considering an orthodontic treatment for you or your children? Dr. Philip Caparuso, a Notre Dame parent of four, is conveniently located at the end of the Milford Green. Dr. Caparuso is a board-certified orthodontist and a preferred Invisalign provider. A proud GoGreenKnight.com sponsor, you can visit Dr. Caparuso online at drcaportho.com or call 203-874-5400. Let Dr. Caparuso bring out your best smile.
For the last 10 years, Federico and Setti has served individuals and business clients throughout the Northeast. Originally founded by Mark Federico, class of 72, the current principals are Michael Federico, Notre Dame class of 82, and Lynn Setti, Sacred Heart Academy class of 82. Providing accounting, tax, audit, and consulting services, Federico and Setti is the perfect company for your personal, corporate, estate, and gift tax returns. A proud sponsor of GoGreenKnights.com, call Federico and Setti at 203-248-9966 for all your accounting needs.
Many times bad things happen to good people. A car accident, a divorce.
Looks good, doesn't it? But you forgot something. All that saturated fat. Why not try Longini sausage instead? Other leading brands contain more than twice the saturated fat than Longini. Made with all natural ingredients, perfectly spiced with just enough salt, Longini sausage is the healthier choice. Made fresh locally in New Haven since 1950. Look for the Longini label in your grocer's fresh meat section.
Ivy League Landscaping is a family-owned, full-service design and build landscape company which services Southern Connecticut. We offer digital landscape design and installation. Our interlocking concrete paver system will add beauty to your patio and walkway. We share our location with our own Soundview Landscape Supply. Please visit us at 50 Industry Drive in West Haven. Ivy League Landscaping, from custom design to seasonal maintenance and supplies. Visit our website at ivyleaguelandscaping.com.
New Haven Foot Surgeons and Milford Podiatry Associates specialize in medical and surgical care of the foot and ankle. They have a state-licensed surgical center with a physical therapy center available for all patients. Physicians include Notre Dame graduates David and Robert Novicki, along with Martin Pressman, James Krantz, and Jesse Parks. They are affiliated with the three major New Haven area hospitals, and they participate with most health insurance carriers. With locations in New Haven, Hamden, Milford, and Ansonia, New Haven Foot Surgeons and Milford Podiatry Associates is your GoGreenKnight.com connection to healthier feet. Visit them online at MilfordPodiatry.com.
Are you looking for a professional painter? Then look no further than Notre Dame's own Donald Martone, class of 87, and his company, Decorative and Traditional Painting by DKM, a full-service painting company specializing in both custom interior and exterior painting at residential and commercial settings. They are fully insured and licensed and will beat any estimate. DKM Painting provides services such as popcorn ceiling repair to painting a single room to an entire house. No job is too big or small. For more information, visit his website, www.paintingbydkm.com. Email him at don@paintingbydkm.com or call him at 203-433-2356. For professional painting, look no further than Don Martone and Painting by DKM.
I'm a wild one. fights begin. I am a wild one taming now, running with wolves and I'm on the prowl.
Welcome right back here as we settle in for the third period of play. Dick Naramore, Don Boyle, of course, Mike Lano on the controls, Danny Alvarado, and Scott Duff on the camera work for you tonight. Doing a great job. Certainly do appreciate as the Fairfield Prep Jesuits lead the Hamden Green Dragons through two by the score of 5-3. They've outshot them 20-13. They scored a couple of power play goals. I think that suffice to tell the story thus far, Dick.
Well, and I think the real story, too, Don, is in that second period, not only did Prep go ahead, but the way they went ahead, four unanswered goals, last four goals scored, they just turned it on.
So both teams are back getting ready for this third period of play. Hamden's still in it. They need a good start, obviously, and they've shown the ability to light the lamp today, so it will be interesting. Face off to come at center momentarily. Just want to mention on the CIAC network, we have more hockey coming your way at 3 o'clock, and also on GoGreenKnights.com, the Green Knights of Notre Dame taking on Simsbury. Also, plenty of basketball provided by the CIAC network beginning at 4 today. Check your listings as we bring you some basketball from Hartford, produced by CPTV Sports. My good buddies over there, so they're right on it, and they're bringing you some basketball action today. So we get all kinds of stuff taking place.
I was kind of waiting for the cribbage tournament. But do you know when that is?
That's tomorrow afternoon at 3:30.
All right.
You'll be the only one there. So have fun. All right. We're just underway here in the third period. Fairfield Prep defending down to our right, Hamden down to our left, and we'll get a quick icing call here. Trying to recap the scoring for you if we can. Fairfield Prep early lead, first period 4:04. Goal scored by Nick Pargiello, his first of two.
And that made it 1-0. Hamden scored three consecutive, including one on the power play. Cangelo scored. Pantera on the power play. They also got one from Calabrese. Then Fairfield Prep went to work. They've scored the last three. Wickman, Cochis, and Bargiello. Well, last four, and then David White, as I covered it up. We got a whistle at the drop. Players being separated. And we're just going to have a face-off to the right of Matthew Bett. Face-off coming to the right. David White, Cangelo to take the draw. Sean Henry stolen away by Cangelo. Looks in front, nothing going on. Turns it back to the corner, he's tripped up. Play continues on. They're going to get the official out at center, making the call there, and it's a tripping call, and this will give the green, the Green Dragon the power play try here. A lot of tripping penalties today. 25 seconds into the period. Just what the doctor ordered, I got a feeling if you are a Hamden fan, right?
Yes, absolutely. The box has not been kind to prep.
David White is in the bin off the face-off. Beck had to be quick to make the save. O'Connor pushing and shoving after. Well, one thing you want to do, you want to remain disciplined if you're Hamden right now. You don't want to be taking a penalty.
No, stupid stuff, yeah.
Exactly.
Wow, same play.
Exactly. They got something going off the face-off there. Pretty good job by Regan off those face-offs to lead to a shot on goal. So they've had a couple of tries. Puck dropped down. Barnett tried to play it back to the line. Bargiello will intercept it. Digs after it. Cangelo trying to keep it in along the wall. They continue to clash. It finally squirts out to center ice.
Prep's so smart in cutting off passing lanes, Don. They really they anticipate so well.
Connor tried to lug it along. Taking off his stick. Connor Henry will steal off the right. Carries into the corner. Trying to get away from Regan, who left his skates to play it over into the corner. Now O'Connor to control. There's a Joey O'Connor, cross ice with the pass. Angelo plays it up ahead in the middle of Barnett. He's across the line. Shot on. Tricky shot. Juggled and held on to by Matt Beck. Face-off upcoming. I like that shot right there.
It was nice. Yeah.
Lano's doing all kinds of work for us, pushing buttons and tweeting for us. Brought me a coffee because he had to.
Uh-oh. Better hurry.
Angelo down the wing. 58 seconds remaining on the Hamden power play. Taken by DeMore and wheeled around and back down into the Hamden zone. Coming out of his net, Matt Huff, to leave it behind the net. Here they come again. Bumped in by Riley. He'll give it a chase, and it's going to be covered by Beck for the faceoff.
Nice short hop on that. It wasn't a threat on goal, but it was a nice short hop catch by the goalie. Looks like he might be, they might be looking for him at shortstop on the baseball team. About 30 ticks left on the penalty clock here, Don.
There's a quick turnaround shot, blocked away. Back to the line, O'Connor, across to Angelo. Knocked off his stick by Lockery. And the puck back into the corner. Battle for it there. Brown tried to tie it up along the wall. Scotty came away with it. Tried to play it out to Barnett, and it's stolen and sent down with 11 seconds remaining on the David White penalty. This is O'Connor carrying in to the left circle. Plays it down below, still control, slips it out front, and it's intercepted again by Bargiello. O'Connor got right to it to keep it in, only momentarily, chopped ahead, and here he comes, David White, out of the sin bin, breaks in on a 3-on-0, takes the pass, can't get the shot off, and they score finally. They put it out front, and they score. Wow, that was a wild play. If it's Bargiello, that is the hat trick on a strange play.
Wow.
I think we'll let the replay tell the story.
Oh, my God. What were there, four passes there?
Absolutely. We'll see that replay again. We'll
Tim on
a
3-on-0.
David White carrying it in. Took that return feed.
Shot.
Off got a
pass.
Piece.
by Argiello will tip it home for the hat trick.
Wow.
Wow.
That was crazy.
241. That's a hat trick for Bargiello. Yep. They all touched it.
Wow.
That line is so unselfish. I think that was the greatest indication of it, wasn't it?
You could see the unselfishness start right at the blue line on the rush. Already looking for who to pass to.
Absolutely.
Yep. Beautiful thing.
6-3 Fairfield Prep leading. Starting to pull away from Hamden here with 12 minutes, 10 seconds remaining in the period. Puck knocked back out between the blue lines. Swatted along by Chacoin. Now taken by Riley on the far side. Forced back into his own zone. Well, Fairfield Prep has been on a mission all year long. Pass intercepted, Kaloy. Dumped on a big check. Offside. On the play. That was a big
check
by Steven Pantera.
Well, Fairfield Prep right on their goals for average mark here. Six goals here and regular season averaging 5.35, so they're right where they usually are.
Puck sent around to the far side into the corner. Yeah, they've been so consistent. Why wouldn't they be right where they're expected to be?
Boy,
right?
Oh boy.
I mean, you've had a chance to watch them play a couple times. Haven't I?
pretty team to watch.
Yep. Icing call against Hamden. Face-off upcoming. 11:26 remaining here in the third. Fairfield Prep leading Hamden 6-3. More hockey coming your way following this one. Simsbury, much improved team here in 2012-13, taking on second-seeded Notre Dame. So that should be exciting.
That should be. That's, I'm kind of looking at Simsbury as perhaps the Cinderella team here, Don. So I'm anxious for that game. See how they do.
Puck controlled. Angelo will tip it. Giving it a chase as Ugolik into the corner. Knocked down David White. I think he got banged up a little bit. He's slow to get up, but it's actually Kevin Brown, number six. Thank God he's all right. That was a, kind of an odd hit into the wall there. Shot by O'Connor was blocked away. He had players on the doorstep. Now he got a penalty upcoming here to Fairfield Prep. And there's a touch by the Jesuits, and Hamden will go on the power play. So the penalties continue here in the third.
Let's see who he tagged. This guy got him.
Might have been a little bit of a retaliation.
Second
there.
Interference.
Yes, Kevin Brown.
Six.
It was Brown who got knocked down the corner, who I had misidentified there for a moment. That six got all tangled up into his jersey when he got whacked down. So.
Yeah. 4:06.
You're getting real good with that one. Interference, a call on Brown. So Hamden on the power play yet again. They do have a power play goal that was way back in the first now. It actually came with a two-man advantage. And they're trying to get something going down 6-3. Angelo calculating as he takes a look. Throws a pass nearly intercepted by David White. He
had
his stick chopped by Regan, or he was in alone.
Yeah.
Corner to the corner, battling there with Sean Henry. Puck taken away by Connor Henry. Tried to snap it out, could not. Now it's laid up ahead of David White. White controlling, slows it down. Pass across is deflected and taken by Sean Henry. Throws it off a glove of Angelo. Stays with it, does Henry, and bats it down into the Hamden zone. And you have O'Connor and Henry colliding, and we're going to see a penalty, at least one, where they're both going to go here. So face-off, upcoming, and that won't affect players on the ice, just the skaters themselves. Call matching penalties. Let me see. You take off Hamden's best defenseman. You take off Fairfield Prep's best defenseman.
I believe that should only be four hockey.
We got a power play going here. Remember?
Yeah, they got too many men.
No, they stay five.
Oh
on
yeah,
four.
Yeah, that's right. That's right. Yep,
four.
Had
that's
that
right.
one. Yep. So it was what were they off at? 9:57 on the clock.
5:04.
5:04. Yeah.
Puck played up ahead. Here comes the announcement on the penalty, what they're calling for. Would imagine some sort of roughing, hands to the face, something like that. Let's see. Yeah, roughing the call. 4:58.
Okay.
Time of the penalty. Stoppage and play, face off to come at center. Puck thrown down into the Hamden zone, and it's going to be collected by Jacoin. Jacoin will start out from behind. We got 39 seconds remaining on the penalty to Kevin Brown. Hamden trying to get something going here. This is Carroll rambling down the left wing. Skates in the zone, trying to twist around Amore. Put it off the side of the net. It squirts out into the slot, but it's skated away by Edmonds and sent back down the other way.
Wow. Opportunity there.
Angelo to control. Weaves away from Lockery. Comes down the right wing into the circle. Little toe drag. Taken off his stick by Connell. Puck played midpoint. Shot. Nice save by Beck as he went smoothly across the top of the goal mouth on the wrister by Pantera.
All even now, Don.
Yep, Brown is back. Shot tough angle. Hit a stick, ricocheted off the back wall. Wickman gets to it, trying to clear it out. Kept in by Riley. Played it up ahead to Carroll. Plays off a check. Carroll's weak pass intercepted by Lockery. Lockery from the corner lofts it up ahead, and it's corralled by Pantera and played up ice. Touch to Riley. Riley across, snaps it off. Beck save, rebound. Riley chopped at it. Wow, another chop at it by Carrigan. Puck finally played out the center ice by Coaches. He scored back in the second for Fairfield Prep. They got a hat trick from Nick Bargiello today. They have been on a scoring tear after falling behind 3-1. They have scored five in a row to make no doubt about it here with 8:02 left, I got a feeling. Gastaldi plays it far side. Barnett chomps at it. Damore will keep it in. Played it behind the net. Players continue to work after it. Now it's free to center. Edmonds with a steal. Ducks across the line off the right. Has some speed. Looks in front. Centers it there. Was deflected right back into his skates. He's tied up along the boards by Riscotti. Puck played out ahead, and it's taken away again. The Jets were starting to really dominate all three areas now. They're into that smooth play right now. That's McKinney. He'll backpedal with it. Plays it off to the left wing side. Controlled by Brown. Brown trying to maneuver across the line. He was wrestled at and was able to work it down below that goal line extended. Taken away. Quick pass. Henry shoots. Score. Connor Henry on the feed for Petrucelli. And the Jesuits add yet another. 7:55, time of the goal.
No doubt about that one.
It was pretty work down low. Looks as though when I mistakenly put 9 up on the board for Fairfield Prep, all I was doing was reading into the future.
Yeah.
It's going right now. Connor Henry with his first of the game.
Assisted by 6, Kevin Brown.
Kevin Brown.
And 26.
Well, that was McKinney they're going to give that to. Thought it was 25.
Yeah.
So Matt McKinney with the assist. Puck thrown cross ice by Calabrese. Had that goal that certainly gave a lot of hope to Hamden back in the second period. Now Carroll trying to keep it, and he does. Good work into the circle. Down low shot, tough angle. Beck will make the stop, and he had to go find it. Let's see if we have a replay on that final, that last goal by Connor Henry. Good feed to Henry right there.
Oh. Yeah. No one covering the middle of the slot area there.
Goal set up by McKinney on that nice feed. Puck thrown back down towards the Hamden line. Margiello across the line, up ahead for David White, just out of his reach. White will give it a chase. Pantera trying to turn away from the forecheck. Margiello will steal it. Whirls in front. Now carries back to the line it goes. Damore cross ice. Rush with a shot redirected just wide of the net with 6 minutes remaining here in the period or so. 7-3, Fairfield Prep leading. At one point they trailed 3-1 offside against Fairfield Prep. We'll have a face-off upcoming.
Well, for all you youth, young hockey players out there, if you want to see the difference of good hockey, it's all about keeping those feet moving, Don. Prep just does not stop. There's no watching any play. They're always moving. Cutting off passing lanes, everything.
This is DeMore from behind. Plays it to the corner. Collector there by Bayless. Tried to work it out. Barnett stole it. Comes back to the line. Scotty will keep it in. Back to Barnett. Tried to spin it in front. Could not. Collected on the far side by DeMatteis to the line. Poked along by O'Connor behind the net. Wraparound attempt is deflected. O'Connor has it midpoint. Plays it off the boards into the corner again. Now they work it with Scotty. Slips it to Barnett. Quick shot. Save is made. Rebound in front. And Beck will stop that too on the backhand. Tried by Michael DeMatteis. And he'll hold for the faceoff. Good work by that line down low.
Very nice defensive work there. Clearing out the bodies too after the save.
Faceoff to the left of Beck. Off the faceoff. Battle for the puck. This is Edmonds streaking down the wing. Got a 2-on-1. Edmonds across, takes a look, score. Used his wingmate as a decoy and scores. Timmy Edmonds makes it 8-3. Well, they're starting to get all the odd man rushes. Of course, Hamden's starting to take some chances, Dick. And 9:51 time of that goal.
Yeah, right off the shoulder, too. Hoff had a shoulder on it.
See the replay on that one?
Yeah.
Just didn't come out enough.
Fairfield prep goal scored by number 20, Tim Edmonds. Assisted by 25, Mike Petroselli.
Petroselli the helper. 9:51 is the time. So 8-3 Fairfield prep leading, under 5 minutes remaining here in the third period. Of course, they'll make a fresh sheet of ice, and both Notre Dame and Simsbury get a chance to warm up, loosen up a little bit. Notre Dame wanted to play the earlier game. They have a big event, their Grand Night auction tonight, and Simsbury couldn't play early because a lot of their young men were taking the SATs.
Ah. You know, it's a shame when academics gets in the way of sports.
Absolutely, too. I know. You ever think of that? I guess sports in Torrington are in jeopardy. They're going to go to pay to play. And
Torrington?
They're going to drop a few sports.
I haven't seen that.
Yeah. Shelton already.
Well, the hit squads are coming out here now, Don.
Yeah.
There you go.
I just don't want to get kicked out of a game if you're Fairfield prep and being eligible for the next. We've seen that happen to teams. White, they rule he's onside, tried to sneak through the check of Coleman. Picked up by Connor Henry. Bargiello plays it back to David White in the corner. Connor Henry knocked off his stick. Henry controlling along the boards, bats it along to Bargiello. Bargiello tried to turn it off the boards. Now Henry back to the line to Moore, throws it in front, redirected by Bargiello. Wrap around a tip! And that's going to be blocked away by Chacoin. Nice work by Chacoin.
Yeah.
Back behind. Connor Henry. Bargiello, quick shot right through the goal mouth. Well, he got a quick release there. This is David White. White over to Sean Henry. Tees it up and drives one. Hop the save, and he'll cover. And that was some puck possession right there, my friend.
That sure was. There's their top five right there. That is clearly their top five.
Off the faceoff, puck played up ice, down into the Fairfield prep zone. DeMore has it. Give it away on that fire side.
That's a pretty rare cough up by him.
Absolutely. Out the center. This is Aiden Smith, plays it right back in. So both teams getting a chance to get some of the younger players on the ice also in this one with a score 8-3 and just above 2.5 left. DeMore just wheels away. Beautiful move away from Tyler Angelo. Talked about his skating skills earlier. Puck on the far side. Up ahead. Shot. Hop got a piece of that. It was Ryan Deering, the sophomore, who had a chance at it. This is Regan. Goes cross ice trying to bank along to Kerrigan, but he was stood up there by Hanel. Did a nice job not allowing to find any open space, but no,
no ice.
Interference call either. Yeah. I think if this game was 4-3, you might have seen a penalty a second ago there.
Yeah.
And Riley.
Palming the whistle right now.
Under 2 minutes left. Gehring played it back. And now able to spin away from Riley's forecheck and then bank it around. Petroselli trying to get to it along the board. Brown had it slapped off his stick. Carroll with the steal. Puck still down in the Fairfield prep zone and behind with 90 seconds remaining. So Fairfield prep will move on to the semifinals. They're going to take on the winner of Xavier Ridgefield. That game at 2:30 today at the Bennett Rink in West Haven. So that one's just getting underway. We'll try to bring you some reports on that one. That's going to be a good one.
Yeah, that's going to be a real good one, I think.
If I wasn't here, I'd be there. Petroselli carries across the line. We're going to get the scream of 1 minute remaining.
1 minute.
And there it is. Calabrese. You could use a public address announcer's call of 1 minute remaining as your wake-up call every morning. How would you like that? 1 minute remaining. 1 minute. he is loud. I don't think I want to start my day off with that. 1 minute remaining. What?
You might market that, Don.
Yeah,
I know. Start an alarm clock business with hockey calls.
That's a good idea. You just stole it from me, see? All right, Fairfield prep, convincing win here. 8-3.
I haven't gotten my patent request in yet, so you're still good.
And tear to control. I'll tell you what, this Hamden team threw a scare into the Jesuits when they opened up that 3-1 lead in the second period, and Jesuits all business thereafter as they go on to score. What, 7 unanswered goals? Is that right? I can't count that high. 7 unanswered. We'll take a quick look at the highlight of the goals. Before we bid adieu and get ready for our next, but there you
That's
go, 8-3 final.
Yeah, you're absolutely right, 7. Pretty even on shots,
23-22. Yep. So Fairfield Prep moving on to the semifinals. They'll play Wednesday here at the Ingalls, either 5:30 or 7:30 against Xavier Ridgefield winner. 4-5, so they're going to get a tough one there. Xavier's been one of my sleepers in this tournament. Ridgefield has also been very impressive.
Yeah.
Had a chance to watch both those teams, Dick. So
I haven't seen Ridgefield this year.
I haven't.
Certainly saw Xavier. Yeah, at least statistically on paper, it looks like it's going to be a good one, though.
Absolutely. All right, let's take a look at those highlights. They start way back in the first period. Fairfield Prep would jump out to the early lead as they were lugging that puck along throughout the game with a lot of success. Let's see what we got here. This will be a, we don't know what we have, so we're just surprised to see what we get here. That's going to be a good scramble there. Cariangelo's goal for Hamden, that tied it back in the first. So we didn't have the first goal of the game scored by Nick Bargiello. As, of course, Bargiello's goal with the first of three as he scored the hat trick. Now we're going to see another goal here. We'll get these in before. We're practicing with our instant replay here. Whereas, we'll try to get them in. They get it sooner or later is better than not at all, right?
Well, both teams showing a lot of respect there on the handshakes. A lot of, it's a couple pairs of buddies out there, and congratulations. Best part of the game. Well played by both teams. Just the result got a little lopsided there.
Absolutely. We'll see these now replays in rapid fire as they really came in rapid fire for the Fairfield Prep Jesuits after falling behind 3-1. This is Hamden's goal here that I believe is going to be a goal. This is Fairfield Prep coming back. And this is when their barrage started right here, Dick.
Yeah.
I might watch the whole period before we see it.
Yeah. And then, that's Ray Russo.
Yeah, coach is on the doorstep. And this is that terrific
rink-wide
push-up. Yeah.
Yeah.
just kind of watch him. All right. That's good work. We got some things to do here between games, so we didn't want to watch the whole game over again. You can do that online, however. Watch the whole game over. We'll have replays up, too, so we do promise. Great work by all. And Dick, of course, Scott Duff, Dan Alvarado, my man Mike Lano behind the scenes. That's game one on GoGreenKnights.com. Game two, Simsbury, Notre Dame, West Haven. That's all upcoming in just a bit. Goodbye for now for the Ingalls. Your final score one more time. Fairfield Prep 8 and Hamden 3.